Let us rock and roll. What is this music? I'm trying out pretzel for the first time. And it's interesting. Go upbeat. Let's get some energy. I think a sub-expression is the only way around that. Crowless is now following me. Thank you very much. What's up? Hope I pronounced your name right. Crowles, maybe? Crowless? Oh, I didn't see your message. Sorry, it's a bit of a delay. So I wrote a module a couple of months ago, a few months ago for Configuration Manager, where I don't know how familiar you are with Configuration Manager, but you can use it to manage content on distribution points. So you can kind of see here in VS Code on the left, public folder, you know, you can get DP content, get a DP group content, you can remove it. You can start distribution to a DP or a DP group, compare DP content or a DP group content, various functions around managing content. And I'm on the last function where its purpose is to find content based on a given ID, and the ID can be anything, with the practical example being, if you're looking for a log file one day and you stumble across this ID that you recognize, but you're not familiar with the environment, you don't know what type of object the ID represents, you just want to be able to throw it into something and for it to spit back, okay, this is what it is. Yeah, well, no, I'm glad you're pumped. I was totally pumped writing it, and then it like consumed a month of my life and it quickly got less and less exciting. So I left it for like 2 months, and now here I am trying to just finish it because I know it can be good. But yeah, the idea being that this function just, you throw in an ID, spits back out what it is. So for example, the main body of it in this process block, it will recognize model names for applications, deployment types. Maybe later on tonight, I'll throw in the brain so it manages the model names for drivers, the CIIDs for configuration items and baselines, CIIDs for, again, application deployment types and drivers, because they can also have CIIDs and model name type IDs. And just your bog standard package IDs, which also look like collections as well, collection IDs, device and user collection IDs. So looking for them as well. So in you can see these lists of WMI classes. It's going to look in package, driver package, image packages. The idea being that you can literally just throw any ID at it, and hopefully it will just walk through your site server in WMI. and just give you back a match, you know. But if you're really excited, probably a couple of decent functions you might like is export DP content. So one of the examples here might give you a bit of insight. I don't know how that clear that is for you, but let me zoom in. On the examples here, so for example, if you get DP content on a given distribution point, you can just pump all of that content out to a directory. All right, and so it'll give you the file type is pkgx, I think. It's just a wrapper for the publish commandlet in the configuration manager module. Then once you've got all that, you can then take this module to your new distribution point. You know, say for example, you've got a new DP set up. You could take that content, those pkgx files, take this module, and then use the import counterpart, import DB content, where it's just a wrapper for that extract content.exe. I don't know how familiar you are with pre-staging files, but the idea being that, let me show you again an example here. You point it at the folder that contains those pkgx exports, and it will just churn through them and import them. Yeah, man. No, there's quite a lot of people on. I've seen quite a few people on Twitch writing PowerShell. It's definitely what inspired me to start. I don't, you know, aspire to become the bee's knees, but it certainly engages my mind a lot better, you know, when I'm focusing, so I can talk about it more. And sometimes you get someone who jumps in and, you know, point something out, like a nice little tip, and that's really got, that's gold, really, having someone do that in the chat, you know. It's now on GitHub if you're keen. Like, all the functions are there and all the functions work, right? Except that find CM object. I forgot my username and URL, sorry. Let me put that in the chat. Yeah, just did. There's probably a bit of delay in the chat. Should be on the gallery, but all of them work. There's a reasonably spec'd out readme that'll give you a lot of tips on how to use it. Definitely let me know if you've got a problem with it. Yeah, like I say, just this one function left and I'm done, and then I'm probably going to do a blog post on it just to help people know how to use it. But I'm almost done. I've not got much left to do. I can't even remember what I was doing now. Object ID, I think I was doing collections. Yeah, it was collection ID. Collection type, got the enum for that. Cool. I've done collection and get rid of that to do. I don't know if it's normal. I'm pretty new to Twitch, to be honest, so it's my first sort of... Okay, right. So where did I... Yeah, I do need to pipe that, and I will do that. It's interesting. I don't know why they do that. That's strange. The packages. This would be pretty much everything else. So I get the result, and once I've got the result, I check if it's basically null or not. Yeah, that doesn't make any sense why I do that. That doesn't need to exist, I don't think. I think I did that last night, I was very tired. Okay, seeing as I'm here, I may as well do that. I can't remember what it looked like. What does it look like? Let's get a package ID for... Things are package IDs, they're all lazy properties, so you have to call them once and then call them again to get the lazy property. And I want to test out a package ID for an application. SMS. Root SMS site. Let's just get the first one. Instant. I did spell it right. Yeah, here we go. Package ID. So here's an example, right, of using that function. Let's use it verbose as well. I've got a... Ignore the fact that I know what the object is. I've just picked out a package ID using find cm object. Just pass it an ID. I'm going to use the verbose parameter so we can see the get sim instance calls. And you can see that it walked through many classes first. So what classes did it walk through? SMS package, SMS driver package, image package, and so on. And it found a match and it returned it. There's a lot of properties here. I'm going to trim that down to the essentials. I don't know, actually. I shouldn't trim it. Do you have a lab? Yes, I do. This is what you're looking in right now, my lab. I have two optiplexes that are right behind me in that cupboard. One that I'm precious about, which hosts the VM that we were just in, the SCCM VM. And the other one, which is kind of like throwaway. I use a lot of the PowerShell module automated lab. I built some custom roles for it for configuration manager, meaning that, well, if you're not familiar with automated lab, basically it's a PowerShell module where you can spin up virtual machines on Hyper-V, yeah, VMware as well, I think, but Hyper-V is mainly what I use. And yeah, so I wrote some custom roles for SCCM. I wrote two, one for 1902 and 2002. The 2002 is awesome. It's a lot better than 1902 because it supports technical preview, various other fixes. So if you're keen in standing up a config manager lab, check it out. The code for that is also in a different repo, but on GitHub. Yeah, definitely. It's just handy, you know, having a lab. The best way, you know, there isn't a best way. It's just a case of getting stuck in. So I kind of have three servers behind me, and I say servers, they're all just homebrew desktops. One of them is for my own home stuff, you know, like media and various other VMs, and two are meant for work, really. I say work, they're not, you know, they belong to me, but I do whatever I want on them for the benefit of my career. That's that sort of idea, at least. So I've got, you know, DC and a couple of generic servers, SCCM, a few Windows 10 clients. but start cheap, you know. Dell Optiplexes. I got two 7010s behind me. I mean, third gen i5, it's not amazing, but, you know, they have a capacity of 32 gigs of RAM, which is a lot, really, if you think about it. You know, set dynamic memory on here, and you can see that DC is not using much, and, you know, between them all, between running four simultaneously, I've still got plenty of headroom. Just jump on eBay, get yourself an Optiplex or something similar, maybe build one, whatever you fancy, really. But there's no better way than just getting stuck in. Yeah, nice. 3050 is newer. I think that's, I don't know, it's got to be at least 7th gen, I think, I'd imagine. But if you think about lab in terms of, like, you know, like Windows environment, definitely look at automated lab. I keep giving you links, but I'm giving you another one to automated lab now. Maybe you've seen it, maybe not. But it's simple, right? It's almost declarative in the sense that you just say, right, I want a domain controller, and I want the domain to be blahblahblah.com, and I want it to have these characteristics, and, you know, you set it to build and it goes and does it, right? It's good. So what I was thinking here was, so when I find an object, I kind of filter after the fact by selecting only a handful of properties. Do I do that? That's the question. Do I narrow the user's view on what's returned, or do I give them everything? Because at the moment I'm giving them the bare essentials. So, like, the essentials meaning, like, if it's an application, if it's of a CI variety, at the very minimum return a CI ID, because a lot of the configuration manager commandlets use CI ID as a parameter. But I'm starting to think maybe I shouldn't filter and just return everything, because, you know, there's no harm in it, right? More is better. But it's not clear, that's the only drawback. The ISO for Config Manager SQL? No, strictly evaluation. Yep. Automated lab will take care of the downloading of the evals for you. SQL, definitely. And also Config Manager. Yeah. I have an MSDN subscription as well through work, so I've been quite fortunate, actually. I don't have to worry too much about that. I think I'm going to stick with the idea that I filter properties rather than giving them everything. Purely because you want something that's clear. For example, object type property is clear. It just says what it is. Like, is it application? Is it package? Deployment type? What? So I think I'll stick with that. How did you find the link to this stream? Is it Twitter or something? Oh, nice. Well, what are the chances? You're an SCCM admin and you land here. It's crazy. Nice. That's a good tip. Thank you. Yeah, definitely. I do intend to. I think this is like my third stream. I did one earlier today, not straight after work, and raged quit because I found a class I didn't quite understand. But no, that's very kind. Thank you. That's a good tip. Dude, thank you, but there's so many more people who are really, really good to watch and follow, you know, like Brett Miller, Chrissy Lemaire. There's a dude who works on Microsoft. What's his name? Is it la? About the PowerShell Live team. If you don't already know it, there is a PowerShell Live sort of group. Yeah, let me paste this in the chat. Follow those guys, and if you set mobile notifications, you're Tyler, that's him. Yeah, he's really good to watch. He's well, he works at Microsoft, so he's good to watch. Yeah, definitely. One place I really recommend is the WinAdmin's Discord. Let me paste the link to that. If you join in the Discord, there's also a bridge to Slack if you don't like Discord for whatever reason. There's a PowerShell channel in there that's quite active. Oh, awesome. Excellent. Oh, that's good. Yeah, the Config Manager channel is probably the most active, but there's an abundance of people all over, and all channels very, very helpful. Very, very, very good. There they are, yeah. Definitely. But no, I wouldn't, going back to your remark about scripting and coding, there's always this debate about is scripting development, you know, I mean, I don't know, personally, I think it is. It depends how far you go with it, right? Depends how much you're automating, you know, how many things you're joining up. But I would never underestimate PowerShell. I do believe it could be like the next Python, you know, without a shadow of a doubt. Just trying to get the see if the driver class had a name. It does. It trying to standardize on the output, which stuff returns, you know. So like I started here, name, description, object type, ID. That's what I have up here, right? Name, description, object type. Yep, ID, makes sense. Cool, excellent. So when I was doing the application, yeah, I think when I was at uni, that's when I first started sort of tinkering with programming, and Python was the first language, and I thought it was great at the time, because, you know, I mean, it is great, there's an abundance of modules, you know, there's resources flying everywhere to learn it, I mean, yeah, and it runs on Windows, runs on Linux, but you're 100% right, it's when you compare Python and PowerShell in a Windows admin world, PowerShell's already there. Windows PowerShell, at least, anyway. So yeah, definitely, I agree. Python is awesome, but for a Windows admin, I agree, it is harder to do something. It's harder to even get it on the... Well, it's not hard to install it, but you know what I'm saying. Oops. Let's retest that now then. So that should return the same, but with a lot less noise. Excellent, good. Just gonna pop a description in that application as a test. Oh, you can't search and see ID in the console. Version was at Firefox 6603. Test description. Just waiting for the description text field to populate, but I can see in the background the ad. The UI is still working. Should be there now. Ooh, that's interesting. It's very possible the CI ID changed. Or it just... Yeah, it did change that. Well, did it? Is that what I put in? I'll do it on package ID. Okay. It's interesting. Move to the. Yeah, the CID must have changed. What was it before then? Wow, it did. Yeah, the CID changes every time you make a change to an application. I didn't know that. I thought they were static and lived forever. That's, interesting. Put that in the WinAdmins channel. See if anybody. Okay, cool. This is coming together now. This is getting pretty close. I just need to work out. CIs. But I could probably do driver model name real quick. Just gotta get the name of them. As an example, there you go, model name. What does that look like? So that's gonna be very similar to this. Forward slash, and it's driver, and then it's pretty much anything, right? I need to put this in regex101.com to understand if it matches or not. Putting back on dark mode on that, because that is painful. What am I doing? That's interesting. Do you reckon it's sensitive on case? Yes, it was. Oh, there was something earlier on that I thought was sensitive on case. Yes, it was this. Oh yeah, that's nightmare that. Did I get around that? Oh no, I got distracted, didn't I? Yeah, no, I don't have a fix for that. I made a project in my company. I didn't make the module, but I had to compose a PowerShell module for infrastructure for the client health. How do you mean? So you made a module for client health? What, for Config Manager? Oh, okay, gotcha. Have you seen the Anders Rodlands client health script? That's a web service and you can write to a database. think it's that. It's this. The script is really cool. What, as in your one? Oh, Anders Rodland. Yeah, no, that's what I mean. Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, definitely. He's also got that on GitHub. I think Technet's going away soon. I think I remember reading about it. Which would suck, really. It's a lot of history, though. Oh wow, you are miles away. I'm in England. Do you know what? I work in tech every day and it still blows my mind just how connected we all are, one way or another. Oh, I seem to have found a solution. I didn't think I did. Oh, I don't need that if I'm doing that, right? That makes sense. That would be where I went wrong. Yay! Now these days everyone is coding in Azure. To see someone work Configuration Manager, it's really cool. Thank you. I don't know if you saw, but I've also written, I don't know, I'm kind of blowing my own trumpet here, but maybe it's rare you get to speak with someone who's also a Config Manager admin, but this script I also wrote, it tells you what folders on disk are not used by Configuration Manager. You basically point it, you give it a UNC path or a local path. It will walk through all content objects or packages, applications, and try and determine which folders are or are not used. And you don't have to be too fussy about what format of the UNC path you give it, because for example in some of your packages you may use a different UNC naming convention, so you may use FQDN or just the BIOS host name, or sometimes IP. I don't know why you would, but you could. You don't have to worry too much about that with the script, because what will happen is that when it gathers all of your content objects, so your applications and packages and so on, for every object it will create an all paths property, which is a valid permutation, many valid permutations of the original source path. And what it will do is that it will go through every folder and every of these content objects and just ask, am I an exact match? Or do I at least start with to understand if it's either an exact match or a child or a parent folder? That helped me a lot when I got a new job, because it was a very, very large VHD filled with just content and they didn't know where to start with cleaning it. So I wrote that. Right, I fixed that regex. I'd never actually finished that, so that's I keep hopping between and it's driving me mad. Okay, so I ruled that out. But the regex is good. Fine. Give it a laugh. I now have to update this function to take not just CID but also model name as well. What? No! Who set this up? Oh no, that is not what I want. Okay. Oh, ridiculous, isn't it? Stupid admins. Why can't I find the... For crying out loud. What do you do when the evaluation is over? You just rearm it. Yeah, there's a command you can use just to initiate another 6 months. It's SLMGR stroke rearm. SLMGR. Yeah. I think it's that, rearm. Yeah. I mean, this one's licensed through MSDN key. But yeah, but if you use the rearm parameter, it should give you another 6 months. Yeah, should give you another 6 months. Focus, 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 focus. So we select a different property. Yeah, I remember now. It's a hoopla up here. Used here. So the theory being that if I use a model name of a driver, it should work. Right? Yeah. Apparently. That doesn't make sense. What's going on then? Why doesn't that work? I don't know why it's not working. I know why it's not working, because I'm not even calling the function. What an idiot. Plum. There we go. Excellent. Now what if I give it the CI ID? Does it still find it? Yay! Now just CIs and then I'm done. I don't know, it's 10:30. Do you reckon I could do it tonight? Maybe tomorrow? It's my fiance's birthday tomorrow. I'm not coming online, so I better do it now. So what class do I want to look in for CIs? by asking many dumb questions is how I've got mediocre at PowerShell. Yeah, no jokes. There's a lot of people in the WinAdmins Discord who have spent a lot of time explaining stuff to me, pointing me in the right direction, that sort of stuff. No, it's just by asking for help. You know, we're very lucky with the people in WinAdmins Discord. We're very, very lucky to have some very talented people. They're very, very helpful. Maybe look to see if there's like local user groups for you, where you can, you know, present or watch people present. You can learn a lot by other people. Probably, in my experience anyway, learn a lot from people more than training material. Don't know why. And just by fumbling around, I guess. This is what I discovered earlier. A lot of CIs are also global conditions. Oh, and configuration item also includes drivers. Oh, that's interesting. Is there a type property as well? Yeah, there is CI type ID 14. Free. Interesting. Yeah, it is cool. Very good. It's a very good tool. Yeah, I should look at the latest. Oh. This CI stuff's a bit of a minefield because, yeah, so many things are CIs and Config Manager. So in here, we've got a mix of actual configuration items, global conditions, drivers. Baselines. I probably didn't need to look in the SMS driver class, but probably. I guess with the benefit of looking at the SMS driver classes, that I could also allow the user to search by a model name, so for a driver, which might be rare. I doubt any logs actually print the model name of a driver. I think this is what I want. So what's configuration item settings? Oh, I think the settings of CIs. Yeah, that would make sense. Rules. I'd imagine those are like condition rules of global conditions or CIs. So what's the difference between configuration item latest and configuration item latest base class? They seemingly have different things. And spot checking random, they all have an is latest. Well, they're both latest classes, I guess. I just wonder what the. They probably have a functional difference. in terms of instances inside them, maybe not many, if any. I'm inclined to use the configuration item latest class for CIs and baselines. What information do we get? So we get the CI ID. We can do model name. We get name. Localized name and description. Nice. Excellent. I could do that, yeah. No problem. And these are CIs. So CI ID type is 3 for CIs, and for baseline it's 2. So how are we going to do that? We want to accept model name. Is there a model name? There is. So very similar structure to how these work. We have parameter sets and the way we build the query. Okay. Find CM. If I do CICB, how obscure is that? Well, one thing I definitely need is an enum for it. I think the property name was CI type ID. Function is misspelled, is it? Oh, thank you. See? If it weren't for you, I probably would have tested it and rage quit. And you're actually watching, so that makes me feel a bit more nervous because someone's judging me. we got 2 possible values. I'm just going to Google the class real quick. Double check. Sometimes this is well documented, but not all the time. Baseline for 2. 3 for operating system. That's not right. Yeah, that's... Oh, it's the base class, that's why. I don't want the base class. Alright, let's not look at the latest one then. There we go. That's just where I was. Yeah, This is what I mean about the documentation. It's not great, but they know this. It's not terrible. It's just 90% sure that is a CI. If there's any other identifier, is there? Platform type. What's platform type? Platform, no. Okay, no problem. Just build it with what I know rather than what the doc says. Would be the first time. Configuration item. That should be a baseline. I think that I said that was value 2 and this one's value 3. Go back here, find CMCICB. I'm just gonna copy these. I could probably reduce these functions into one, but the only thing that would make it a bit tricky is when I select the properties in a WQL query, and also the calculated properties. So I could, but maybe another time I'll think of that. Can't remember the names of the properties now. CID still localized display name. There's a lot of repetition here now, that's the only problem. Properties are going to be the exact same as, yeah, there's quite a bit of repetition here. I'm going to have to think about how I can reduce it, but still keep it readable, you know, that's what's important. Name description, driver, okay. What's the name of the enum that I just made? And then the property name is CI type ID, pretty sure. CI type ID. That's what I did. So let's test that. Let's grab me an ID for a baseline or a CI. Let's first use some CI ID. Find CM object ID. Didn't work. Where did we get to? Did I call the function? No, I didn't. That's why. I've done that twice now. Pissing myself off. Oh man. Alright, so what does the model name of a CI look like? Just logical name. There's even some form of repetition here in the conditions, right? I'm 90% sure that'll pick it up, but we'll find out in a minute. So what do we have? Find CMCICB model name, sim parameters, get sim splat, and then the same. Let's just test that real quick with a model name. Grab one of my clipboard. Quick. Good. Let's implement it for. Yeah, this whole section here, I just don't like the way it looks. I just hate this check on variable, and it's just all just. I couldn't think of a prettier way. Oh, glad you're here. That's why I do it. It's good to have people watch. It's like someone pinged me. Ping me on Discord. Try a catch. So, yeah, the thing is, so these functions use getSim instance, and so long as there's nothing wrong with the query and there's nothing wrong with the connection to the host, if it's remote, getSim instance generally doesn't throw an exception for trivial things, like if there's no match found, like if the query returned nothing, then you know you're not going to get an error, you're just going to get null. So try catch wouldn't really work here, and even if it did, it would be many more lines. And what I needed was like a waterfall approach. This is a good way to explain it, I think. A waterfall approach where, as you can see here, I try a CI or a CB. If not, okay, right, then I try application. Okay, if not, then deployment type and driver, right, and whatever else I come up with now or later. Initially, right, I had it in looking something like if null is equal to, and then I did the function call, which I didn't 100% like, but it kept the number of lines to a minimum. But what I found was is that the result from the function call was never returned to the stream. For some, it just disappeared, you know, and I didn't quite understand why. And no matter whether I wrapped it again or threw it in a sub expression, I don't know. The stream just disappeared. So which left me with this sort of ugliness that I have, where I call it, I return it to a variable, I check if the variable is essentially null. If it's not, dump it to the stream and then continue. Use a continue statement to go back up to the switch statement for the next ID. Yeah, it is weird. I always thought, so for example, if I do it now here, if I do get child item here, I'm pretty sure I will see nothing. Okay, never mind. It's normal behavior, I guess, apparently. I just thought it would have returned the output of get child item, but I guess not. It doesn't, no matter what I do. I wonder if I use the call operator. No, not even that. And what about wrapping it? Oh, then of course, then it tries invoking the string. Whatever. Yeah, no, it's weird. So yeah, that's why I've kind of ended up with this bodgy sort of bunch of if statements, trying to create this waterfall approach of working through until one is matched, and then move on to the next ID with a continue statement. So. But I think that's it. So that's that should be it. That should be good for testing now, actually. Let's quickly work that out. Let's do... yeah, cool, works. But object type's blank. That shouldn't be blank. It's because the property's not returned in the query. That should work now. Excellent. Good. CIs. What else can I do? Whatever's are there. Could, I mean, global conditions, I guess, but do I really want to? When are you likely to see the CI ID for that in a log file? Probably never. I'm going to commit this though. What's changed though? Import. What did I do to import DB content? Oh, just formatting. Added enums. Cool. So that should be up there now. I don't think I need to do anything more. Usually I have like a little to-do pane here. Oh, okay, yeah, apparently I have quite a bit more to do. What's this? Switch to return CM object property. What? Put applications point type actions into a child I have. This switch to not return CM object property. Oh, I think I, yeah, what I was. What I was working on was that I was initially, when I first started writing this, is that not only was I going to return things like name, description, object type, and CIID, I was also going to return another property. Presumably, it was going to be called CM object, and within it was the object that's returned when you use the config manager commandlets. So, for example, if you were to run get CM application, it contained that object within the property. So I don't do that, and I have no intention of doing that. If the user wants to go fetch the object, they can do. This is, yeah. Just trying to reduce my to-do list. Export, perhaps use jobs here, maybe, if I was keen. There are a way to do the lines below. Add secondary support, yep. Spain, yep. Highlight that this isn't the most efficient. I've already done these actually. So what's this to do? I know site server empty, but there's a check that no one must begin functions by the date script. I hope I wrote that down. No, I didn't. It's fine. This actually got closed. Aaron closed this. I had a question about how the secondary site parameters worked. Claiming the SC parameter is for. What did he say the SC parameter was for? Take site code. I thought it was a secondary. primary site code. Oh. Yeah, I completely read that wrong. Is that a secondary? Required only when cleaning content. Just, yep. This connection to the parent primary site must be made distribution points, etc. Quite these are variable. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so I completely misunderstood the parameters when I raised that issue. Oops. I should probably apologize. Thanks, Aaron. So I'd get rid of that then. It can still be used, because if the user is using it from a secondary site, they can just specify the primary site server name. That's it, there's no extra support needed. There's no additional parameters for secondary site. They just update site server, I think. Where's the binary called? Yeah. Args distribution point Q. Oh no, it's not called. Could. Well, let's get out the door for now. If someone wants it, they can request it. No one should be running such child sites anyway. Is there a way to dedupe the lines below? Just so there's one invoke native command call. Probably. Probably is. But it's functioning code. Yeah, they're only disappearing, so I'm deleting them. I'm not actually doing anything with them. It's a mixture of, truth be told, it's a mixture of apathy, or lack of, you know, and just not needed or already complete. I could use jobs, but I actually discovered when I was using this in a prod several weeks ago that there's actually a limit of just 5 concurrent jobs that are allowed to be used for this command anyway. You never see more than 5 files being generated at a time. And annoyingly, if you submit 5, when one completes, another doesn't immediately backfill. All 5 have to finish, and then it queues up with the next 5. So It's literally no different than running one by one. So, perhaps there's some difference, but none that are significant to make me want to mess around with run spaces, because I could do jobs, but I don't think there's a throttle parameter with jobs. I think I'm pretty good to upload. I don't know. I should do more testing, to be fair. Find. So what do? We grab all the model names of applications, deployment types, drivers. I'm gonna retry that with logical name. Logical name is just for CIs. We need baselines as well. Glad I looked again, because that is I wonder if that will match that. Let's test. Re-import you. Let's get the ID of a baseline. Oops. Baseline, whoop whoop, and then we'll test it for the model name as well. Yep, works good. I'm glad I looked at that. So what else can be a package ID? Collections, packages, driver packages, image packages. Anything that's not content related, what else is there? We already have collections. There are global conditions. Those are CI IDs. Maybe I'll do those as well. You have much baselines. Yeah, these are imported, to be fair. These come from the WinAdmin's GitHub repo. The guys put some of the people in the Discord, they put some together so that you can craft a baseline so that you can deprovision some Windows 10 Apex packages. So then you pump out this baseline. I didn't create them manually, they were imported. Someone else already created them manually and uploaded them for us to consume. But their function is to uninstall these. I don't do it in lab. A customer wanted it in production and I didn't know how to do it. So I did it in a lab. Worked out fine. I have a lot of garbage in here that I don't necessarily need. What else we got? Ooh, tar sequences. I haven't done tar sequences. Yeah, I should do tar sequences, definitely. How can I overlook them? They don't have content associated with them. That's how I missed it. Excellent. Cool. Ooh, there's loads of good classes. Could use a baseline to uninstall Apex. Yeah, so let me link you. The reason why we do it by baseline is because in 1809 there was a lot of chatter about it on Twitter. There were several people who noticed it. They discovered that during operating system deployment by tar sequence, the deprovisioning of Apex would sometimes work, sometimes not. You know, sometimes an error would be thrown. And I think someone pinned it down to the apps updating during the build, causing like a resource hog, you know. So yeah, and then like ideas came out. It's like, well, we'll just do it after the build's complete, you know, just create a CI and be done with it, you know. Let me link you to it. Let's try and find it now. Yeah, some people, yeah, that's one way. Some people don't like touching the whim, you know. Some people just like the idea of being able to take out of, you know, VLSE and just throwing it in the tar sequence, keeping it vanilla. Some people like that, but some people obviously, you know, like you, also like to make changes to the whim. The benefit with that is that it's just another solution. Also increases improves build time as well, so the less you do during task sequence, the faster it is, right, to build. I'm trying to find these CIs. Where did they go? You would have thought they'd be in compliance settings. They gotta be. Yep, here we go, they're here. So you can download them as a cab. Drop that in the chat. It's the CB deprovisioned Apex, and there's two options. It's via Posh and it's via registry. The difference being via registry means it just it achieves the same result. I think it deletes keys, I think. Or via Posh, which uses the commandlets to uninstall or deprovision the Apex. It's also another one, reprovision it if you find yourself needing to re-add them back into an already built system. As a cab, which is what you use to import into Config Manager, by the way, in case you didn't know. These cabs, you know, if you go to the console, when you download these cabs, maybe you already know this, but go to configuration items, you can import configuration data, and then you just browse to the cab, see if it wants to look for a cab, and yeah, it gives you that. That's all this is. It's already made for me. What was interesting is that there were many WMI classes prefixed of SMS tar sequence. I have zero tar sequences. That's horseshit. I have many. That's the class. SMS tar sequence package. I deleted all the images. Win and left just the enterprise index, yeah. And from there, I install all the things the company wants. The major thing is that every time a new win comes out, you ... run out of text. Have to build the win again, yep. Was to build some automate PowerShell to do this for me. Wow, dude, it sounds like you have not heard of OSD Builder. It's a PowerShell module dedicated to messing around with the Wim. You can do all sorts, install language packs, install updates, run scripts, yeah, like set registry keys. It's impressive, that. Very, very good. Check that out. Very, very good. It's written by a guy called David Skura. Have I pronounced that right? See if I can find him on Twitter. There he is. Yeah, give him a follow. He tweets some Yeah, I know that feeling. It's a mixed emotion, you know. It's like a huge sigh of relief that it's already out there, but also a bit disappointing because you kind of wanted to do it, but you know. Random banana. So, what does that class take? That class takes package ID. What else? Nothing silly like CI ID or like next. Good, simple. That's what I like. SMS task sequence package. What properties do we have in that? So we have package ID, yeah. Name exists. Do we have description? Yes, we do. And package type. We do, 4. Fantastic. You could do, but in my head it will never be as good as the person who did it originally. But it's a way to practice. Yeah, like all things. Yeah, I agree. Yeah. So yeah, truth be told, when that script I shared with you, get CM on new sources, that was probably my first PowerShell sort of script that I wrote to then upload and share. And I learned a lot. I would say that was probably the start of me tinkering with it. So yeah, I completely agree with that. It's getting a little project, no matter how good or bad you do it. Some people learn more by fumbling around like that. I certainly do. Whereas other people could read information and immediately digest it and apply that information. Some, not all, you know. Let's test out task sequence. That should have found it by now. Interestingly, that should have not gone on for that long. Because the class, yeah. So once it's found it, oh, that bit of code that I found earlier, that's... I deleted code earlier and I remember looking at it thinking, oh, that's weird, why is that there? And deleted it. And I've since committed and uploaded, so I'm going to have to go. I'm sure there's a git command I could use to get the history of a file, but I don't know it. So I'm going to look at the history of... this. Let's try and remember where it is. It's this here. Yeah, see, this is exactly what it was. And the reason being, that lived in a default clause, didn't it? Default block. Yeah, and the reason being, right? The was because what I didn't want to happen was before I try and explain, let me test. No, I don't need to pipe. The object's already... No, it's still doing it. Oh no, it's the count that's the problem. It's an account property. I will read your comment in just a second. Just there. Yep, that's better. It no longer loops through the class unnecessarily. That's good. So what if I give it 2? Does it find both? Yes. Okay, so I learn when there's a problem and don't know where to turn. And I have to find a solution. And I check this, check that. Click here, click there, rage quit. And then somehow I start to have an image in my head on how I solve the situation. I relate to that 100%. Very much. But look, yeah, the WinAdmins Discord, you don't have to suffer alone. There's a bunch of people in there who have gone through probably a lot of the pain that we all go through, including you. So any problems in there, there's loads of people in there willing to help. Yeah, we do suffer together. Especially at the moment. I don't know if you're on version 2002 or not. But there's some serious Pixie and SQL issues going on at the moment. It creeped into Slow Ring. And everyone's got it. Config Manager 2002. I got hit with it today, the Pixie issue. I got a ticket in saying I can't build it, and Pixie was just having none of it. Like, rebuilt it, used the Pixie responder, moved back to WDS, fiddled with the RAM block sizes or whatever. Was having none of it. I saw the tweet from the support guy on the product team. Apparently they're releasing a KB for it very soon, hopefully this week, and a hotfix. Oh, you're on 1910. Okay, cool. Yeah, don't update to 2002 just yet. Wait until they release a hotfix, because there is a known issue with Pixie at the moment. Let me link you to the tweet. That's Frank. UK. The Frank? Yeah, here we go. Yeah, this is the tweet. Yeah, definitely wait until they release a hotfix, 100%. It looks like boot media works. But there's other issues as well. Someone reported about having problems with SQL performance and high CPU. Apparently they're all kind of linked. Don't know how. Sure, this is crazy. I think I finished it. The only thing left to do is I've been contemplating about moving these functions into the private folder, but no other function uses them in the module, so it's arguably pointless. But just for yeah, exactly, there is something else to do. There always is. I don't know, maybe it would just improve readability, you know. Shall we do it? Yeah, sod it, why not? How do they look here? Just functions, yeah. Did I update this? Yes, I did. It won't take too, yeah, I mean, it's easy. What is this music? It's terrible. Why are you still listening? Why are you listening to me? I got this terrible music on. Oh, what's the name of the next one? Find CM driver. Yeah, man, I know. It's a part of this sort of free, royalty-free streaming app I tried. Normally I use this Spotify playlist. Problem is, it's got to be royalty-free, otherwise Twitch will mute me in the playback. Let's switch music. This one's a bit more soothing, this playlist, I find. I'm just currently moving some of the internal functions to script files in a private folder, just for cleanliness, I think. Just so it keeps this function light on the eyes. For no reason other than that, really. Cool. That's that. Let's test. Still works. Cool. So you got any projects? Anything on, Git or anything? Anything on GitHub? Give it a go. Yeah. Something you could do is create a report, get yourself an account, and just create a repository, called a PowerShell, and then put a profile.ps1 on there. I don't know if you customize your own profile on your machine, but you could do that. And just start from there, you know. Yeah. Yeah. It's always a grey area, you know, when you write scripts at work, being able to upload them. Well, sometimes it's not a grey area, sometimes it's just black and white. Anything you write during company time is theirs, generally. But thinking it's not worth it, you know, I mean, yeah, definitely, I can relate to that. There's so many times I've, yeah, felt that way. I definitely relate to that, but if you forget about that and just remember what you said, you know, learning, I guess it's an opportunity to learn. Who knows, you know, it might be helpful for someone. Yeah, I'm ACC. Yeah, what's your handle then? Have we spoke? Oh, cool. Oh, yeah, I think you were in the PowerShell channel yesterday, actually. Yeah, the blog post for that is actually going live on Monday, it's scheduled, so keep an eye out on sysmasquad.com on Monday, the blog post for that will go live. Yeah, I know, it's a bit fanboyish, wasn't it? It's a bit silly. She's cool, she's very helpful, she's very good. But yeah, on Monday a blog post will go live about using the configuration manager custom role for automated lab. There's already one on winadmins.blog, but the one on Sysman Squad will be newer. Be able to upload this to the gallery tonight, which would be nice. I'd be careful about not sharing my API key though. It's probably a bad example to use a really long string like that. How practical is it that you'll actually encounter that? I should give one for each, actually. One for driver, one for them all. Because why not? This music is a bit better. Better than the last one, that's for sure. Yeah, do you know what? I've been thinking so much about the gear I have. What do you think of my microphone then? I've listened back and it's not terrible, but yeah, it's definitely not of the caliber of many other streamers. I've definitely been thinking about the gear I've got though. I've been looking on Amazon for the stream decks and the key lights, and all I've got is a couple of cheap IKEA lamps I've beside me, otherwise there's no hope of seeing me, you know. Before you know it, you could spend loads. Yeah, the camera is good. I waited weeks to get this because obviously since the virus hit, like, it was impossible to find one, and I'm glad I held out, managed to get that on an Amazon warehouse deal. It took me weeks to start streaming though, months in fact. Excellent. Is the text too small, would you say? And how would you say the audio levels compare, you know, with my voice, comparing the level of volume from the music? Could the voice go up? Could the music go down? Could the music go up? 21 questions, I know, I'm sorry. Makes a wall of sound. That's interesting. Okay, I think I'll listen back and is it like a white noise, like a background hustle, noise, buzz? Sweet. I'll definitely, nice one. I'll look back on the recording, see what it sounds like. I'm super tempted to buy new gear though. Let's talk about a COVID mask. Problem is, I've got to save for a wedding. I can't spend too much money. Got to get married. Thank you. have no life anymore. Yeah, you're not wrong. I'm very grateful for mine. She lets me stay up late and tinker. Not many would let me do that. But I'm curious to know what it will be like, you know, when you start a family. Will I still have the time and energy to do things like this? How will that make me feel? How will it make my partner feel? The things she wants to do? The time she loses? I'm sure it'll be worth it, right, when you have kids. Not everybody wants it, yeah. But... I thought for a moment an SMS deployment type had a package ID property. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're 100% right. I'm really glad you joined the stream. Like, nobody's actually really kind of hung around for long enough, especially to ask questions, you know. It's really cool. Hope you come by more. Stick around in Discord for sure. Yeah, definitely. You know, I can say I'm very grateful for the relationship I have with mine. Very flexible, the amount of time I spend. Very understanding. She knows that I'm not just wasting time, I think. I think she knows that I'm doing it for good reasons. Sure, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Right, I need to publish this to the gallery, and I'm going to do that off screen on my other monitor just because of the API key. FA. Are you on Twitter? Because I'm going to tweet that I finish this and I definitely want to tag you. You don't have Twitter. Dude, get on Twitter. Come on. Sign up right now. Right now, do it. Yeah, sign up. Tell me your handle. Just published to the gallery, so that's that. Should be there any minute now. There we go. 1.1. Awesome. Probably got bugs in it, but I can take care of them another time. That turned out to be quite simple, actually. Yeah. As simple as it can be for a WMI structure, that's quite sporadic, you know. Don't know if sporadic is the right word, but I'm proud of it. It's cool. Just got a blog about it now. Barely keep my eyes open. Come on. Soundcare. Is that the handle in Discord? No, it's not. No, I know. I was just checking what it was on them. Couldn't find you though on Discord. Is it really? You commented in PowerShell from. Hmm. Presumably that's you. Maybe. Soul Calf? Maybe. No, it can't be you because you joined 2013. So what's your handle? Ah, the five in there. Yep, gotcha. Cool. There's loads of people you should definitely follow on Twitter. It's a good way of keeping up to date, I guess, as much as you can do. Oh, I should probably update the README as well to include the new function, right? Give me 2 seconds, I will look for you on Discord, but I'm just gonna quickly finish this up. Yeah, you do have a lot to. Cool. You're in the PowerShell group? Is that what you said? Pretty sure you did. In the PowerShell group, yeah. Did you? Today, what, 11:54 PM? Oh, you did. Testing, yeah, cool. Awesome. Let me add you on there as well. Yeah, interesting, I did try searching for you, but I couldn't find you. This way. Yeah, I remember now. Yesterday, yeah, no, it's not. Give you a thumbs up. Probably put line breaks in between each of those examples, actually, looking at that on the browser. Good track, this. Right, this is where I end up. Thank you so much for sticking with me. Honestly, it's actually been really engaging. It's kept me focused, and it was it was good fun. So no, it was good, very very good. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Must be late for you. What time is it in Portugal? To Lisbon, right? Oh, we're in the same time zone. Oh, Western Europe. Gotcha. Yeah, makes sense. For some reason, I thought it was Central European time, but it's not. It's Western. Anyway, thanks so much for sticking with. And stick around in Discord. Speak soon.